Three, two, one.
We just took kind of like the clay off of it this morning, so it's fully molded.
Cool, thank you.
Big crowd this year.
Actually, since we are on the live stream,
inside is sealed, it doesn't, you know, peel off.
Okay, cool.
We just given another layer of
water. This is water and glue, right?
Water and glue.
Nice.
There's a box over there.
The hardest part, yeah. This is what left of the
That was the clay underneath.
Yeah.
So okay. That's what's left.
Cool. Okay, so we went through a lot of it.
Huh?
We went through a lot of it. Kind of. We went through a lot of it. Cool.
We separated the hands and the face. And then
cool. Thank you.
Greetings.
Hello.
Okay, so I'm Howard Bernstein. I'm the executive director of 16th EMC Center. And we've been here since 1978. And our celebrations has been there a long time too. In fact, they were using the third floor for 14 years. From about 1991 to 2005, they were full-time using the third floor. The summer and the spring session events. So it was actually two of them.
Cool.
Really great to have you back. We're really happy to be able to continue hosting the procession. Is that what we call it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Ecological City. Okay.
Ooh.
That's a mouthful.
That is a mouthful.
But yeah.
Yes.
So that's fantastic. And our kids participate every year in the procession.
So I
have
my question.
So
we'll talk about it.
Well, it is a community center, so historically we've had programs for the community. This being a special event, we now have a teen climate justice program. So we work with high school age students who are very involved in the climate crisis and learning about the issues behind it and also advocating
try
for
and, climate
change.
Dry some of that excess stuff out of there.
The last couple of weeks. We run a community support agriculture program, so we work with upstate farmers year round. And we also do emergency food distribution. This is great. So we prepare about 2,000 meals a week, which we distribute in the community and now to many migrants in the city.
I am. I
distribute
used to cover the Mid-Atlantic region.
Oh, nice.
And
so we've got a lot going on here.
I drive down from D.C.
That's
our appointments Monday in Raleigh. Then drive down to
thank you so much. Yeah.
And Monday night.
Yeah, we'll talk to you later.
Theater they redid. So Monday night they and I was like, you know.
Thank you for teaching us how to do it.
Yeah.
So the next prayer. This couple is part of the we are going to make a donation. This is not very good drawing. It's going to be maybe a longer. But all these rectangles are the drawings we are going to make. So we are going to do some
thank you. You're good.
So we have number two is water, river, climate solution. That is the spirit. The spirit, the prophet spirit is called water, river, climate solution. So the idea is represent different elements connected with the water, river. So I find out different fish, plants, oysters are in the Hudson River.
Oh.
1 year, time ago, we made a parade and connect with the Hudson River situation, what's going on in the Hudson River. So I had to research and I find out in the Hudson River we have seahorses, we have oysters. So it's where salty water connected with water from the river. So there are a lot of species connected. So I made a template. This is something you are not going to paint, but yes, our suggestions. So you keep the fabric here and you just draw. And clean up this paint. Yes, that is it.
Okay.
I made some of this.
Okay.
So you can make more than one, but we have 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, yes.
Going over to make sure the three-dimensional face is like the sketch. Then when the clay is set, we Vaseline it, put a layer of paper, newspaper, paper mache, and then the heavier paper. We alternate the brown and the red so you can tell what layer you're on. Then we remove it, clean the Vaseline off, put a final layer on the back with Elmer's glue rather than the paper mache stuff. Let it dry, and we'll start to paint. It's more fun when we can do the projects out here, too.
Yeah. It was crazy windy yesterday.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can I see your butterfly?
There's a lot of string everywhere. This idea. Yeah,
well, that's right.
Grace, can you tell us what you're working on?
These are butterflies for one of the dresses.
So cute.
Yeah, I just added them to this one. Was a little bit of a flash. We don't
have one.
Good example of what they
cook. And look, what brought you to this organization? What's kind of the, what kind of attracted you to your internship here, if you don't mind me asking?
Yeah, well, a lot of it is meeting new people, networking.
Thank you so much for talking to us. Wow. And yeah, so this has been going on for around 4 weeks. And these workshops are happening until May 4th, 12 to 4 p.m., 6th Street Community Center. Come on out. We're working on art projects to wear and puppets to hold for our culminating May 11th Climate Solutions procession. Residence, Johanna Ovira, hard at work, picking on one of our costumes for the procession.
Yeah, and you, like, I try to stack everybody on Sundays. Some weeks don't have like a Sunday mandate, so like tomorrow I'm going back and teaching for like 5 hours.
5 hours.
Yeah.
tell me a little bit about what you're doing right now?
On the bottom, it's supposed to resemble waves.
Do you want to say, like, this is 6th grade, can you use
anything? Thank
you for watching. Come on down to 6th grade Center for Art and Conversation Workshops happening every Saturday until May 4th.